Hi guys, welcome to Cognito Hub Talent Tutorials. In this video, I am going to explain about what is the main use of using T denormalized component, as well as how to use that T denormalized component and where we can use that. I am going to explain in this video. Now, without wasting any time, let's dive into the topic. Okay guys, here what we need is, we need one input file in order to illustrate the T denormalized component. So I have prepared that input file. So let me open that input file once. So this is the input file that I am going to illustrate here. So what I considered here is, one column is student ID and another column is what are the enrolled subject for that particular student ID. Like that particular student is enrolled to what is the subject name. So here what we have is, we have one ID here. And this particular ID with student is enrolled to the subject as algorithms. And similarly, we have three IDs here. So what we can say is, this particular student with student ID 234321 is enrolled to C programming and algorithms, as well as here it is just a, we got one duplicate record as well. Similarly, we have another student ID who enrolled for probability as well as for the data structures. So and similarly, we have another student ID with 123456 and he enrolled for only operating systems. Like that, I have prepared one simple data set. So what the T denormalized component will do is, suppose if you have a look into it, this is a very small file, that's why we can able to trace it out. But if it is a very large file of 10 MB or 20 MB, that means of 10,000 records or 10 lakh records, then with the identification of this, like what is the total number of subjects that a particular student is enrolled for, is very difficult in such type of files. In that cases, the T denormalized component will come into picture. So what this T denormalized component will do is, so here what is the student ID, it will just denormalize what are the total subjects, like what is the column that you want to what is the column that you want to denormalize. It will just denormalize all those components. Suppose what it will do is, here we have one student ID with 234321 and we have total three records for that. So what it will do is, it will just combine all these three records into one, and it will also remove the duplicates if any exists. Then we can easily able to identify, so what are the total number of subjects that the particular student ID is enrolled for. So just in this scenario, I have considered only the student ID and the enrolled subjects, but we can have multiple subjects, multiple scenarios where we can use T denormalized component. So let's go to the Talent Studio and let us explain how this will work, and I will show you the practical example. So I am opening the Talent Studio here. So I already created a sample job named as example_illustration. So first of all, what I am doing here is, I am using T file input delimited. So first of all, I need to do some pre-configuration here. I am giving the predefined schema. One is name, student ID with integer, and another column is enrolled subjects, which is a string. So I am leaving this and I am clicking OK. These are the two columns that we have in the input file, and for the input file, I need to redirect to the path that I have. So I am going to that, which is in T denormalized file. So I redirect to the file txt file. Here the row separator is slash n and the field separator is semicolon. So I kept this, and we have one header named as student ID as well as enrolled subject. So I am keeping it as one. What it will do is, it will just skip the number of rows that we have mentioned in the header. So if you mention 3, then it will skip the first 3 rows. If you mention 1, then it will skip the first 1 row. So this is fine. So we configure the T file input delimited, that means which will take the whatever the file that we created for to illustrate, it will take that file and contain. And what I am using here is, I am using T denormalized component here. We have a component named as T denormalized. I am clicking that. So I am just connecting these two with the main connection and just double click on this T denormalize.
So what it will show is we have one here, one is schema and another one is some section for TD normalize. And so what we have in the TD normalize is one is edge schema and another one is some section for TD normalize. So what I am doing here is initially the schema is empty. So just I am clicking here sync columns, which will directly copy the schema from the input component to the output component. So now we have the schema for TD normalize as well. So that is fine. Now the main picture comes here. The main configuration that you need to do for T denormalize will exist here. So whatever the column that you want to denormalize, just mention here. So if you click the plus button on below the T denormalize, and we have the whatever the column that you want. Here we have only two columns. One is student ID and another one is like enrolled subjects. Here I don't want to match the student ID. Just I want to have a single student ID and corresponding to the whatever the many enrolled subjects. So the relationship between these two are one to many. So what I want to do is I am leaving it student ID, but I am clicking enrolled subjects here. And what are the delimiter that you want in the output? I am just making it as pipe. And what just see how what is the output for this? I am saving it, and I will add some T log growth just for the illustration. But if you are working in some projects, you can add T file output delimiter just like how we are collecting the output files and all. So I am just clicking here T log growth, and I am clicking table here just for the like proper representation. I'm saving it, and if I run this, so I'm started running. So if you have a look into it, previously the output was we have total 9 records, but if you observe the output here, so the 8 records will convert into the 5 rows now. So what is the 5 rows? If you consider the 1 2 3 4 5 6, we have only one subject enrolled for. But if you consider 2 3 4 3 2 1, as I said already previously, this particular student ID is enrolled for algorithms, C programming and algorithms, and as well as this particular row number like student ID 567467 is enrolled for compiler design, and 567437 student ID is enrolled for both two subjects, one is probability and data structures. So this is how you can able to see easily, like there should not be any duplicate values for the student ID if you use the T denormalize component. Like it will simply match the columns with whatever the columns that you want to match. So one more thing is, here we have duplicates as well. Suppose algorithms are there, algorithms and C programming. A one student cannot be enrolled for two subjects at a time, like two same subjects, and it is showing some irregular data. That means there might be in data sets, there might be some error happens there. So in order to eliminate that, what we need to do is, whenever you enroll here, like column delimiter, we have one more option here, like merge same value. Suppose if the same value is present for the enrolled subjects, it will just merge that particular value. So I am clicking this and I am saving it again. So if you run this, it won't appear the algorithm two times. Let us run this. So if you run the output, if you observe the 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1, the remaining outputs are same, but for this output previously we have algorithm, C programming and algorithm, but now that algorithm is merged with the first algorithm. So total we have only unique values in the right side as well. So only algorithms and C programming is there for 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1 student ID. So this is how that T denormalize component will work, and what it will simply do is it will just categorize and it will make the whatever the columns that you want as a unique ID, and it will combine whatever the columns that you want to merge. So this is all about T denormalize component, and in the coming lectures I will going to explain about how to use the normalize component and how to send the mail and all. So that is all for this video, guys. Thank you for watching.